Emotions are really inextricable from the experience of chronic pain. It makes sense that in acute pain, you would be having some kind of acute emotion of anger or frustration. Imagine stubbing your toe. There's an immediate emotional response. It makes sense to me, and perhaps to you, that if we have a chronic pain state, that we could get into a chronic mood state as well. At the Comprehensive Center for Pain and Addiction, many of us across disciplines are interested in this topic. There's an ongoing survey, which is the National Health Interview Survey, which is the premium, well-designed, well-delivered survey that is weighted to be representative of the U.S. population. We found that one of the data sets contained information on anxiety and depression, then analyzed the data in a new way. We were able to explore the intersection of chronic pain and co-occurring anxiety and depression, which was unremitted, with some interesting results. Functional limitations are extremely prevalent in this group. The majority of people will have difficulty across domains, so they'll have difficulty functioning at work, they'll have difficulty participating socially, and in fact, they'll have difficulty participating in daily activities of life, such as getting dressed, going to the doctor, going to the grocery store. So it cuts across not just all segments of society, but also all segments of your life. Ultimately, I hope these findings get translated to the vast national momentum that we have around mental health. Patients will go into their provider for a chronic pain encounter, and the doctor may begin asking them about mental health. And these patients, having been invalidated perhaps by their partners, families, coworkers, neighbors, in terms of whether their pain is legitimate, whether they might not be perhaps exaggerating, whether they could not perhaps be functioning better, they may immediately wonder if they're being stigmatized in a similar way. And so, isn't my pain really just depression or really just anxiety? It would be great if when people come to talk about chronic pain, right away, mental health was part of the conversation. What too often happens today is an exhaustive biological examination, and when all of that is inconclusive, then mental health is brought up, sometimes in the course of discharge. And so while that's not the way that we operate here, that's what's going on, I know, out there in the nation, and I think it's extremely stigmatizing and may even prevent people with experiences of chronic pain that desperately need mental health care from accessing it. That is something that I would like to correct, whether through changing clinical behavior or patient education or a combination of both.